Former New York City Mayor Mike Bloomberg's numbers are on the rise, especially among African Americans. And he's taking those black voters from former Vice President Joe Biden.
I'm a leader who can be honest about my mistakes. And I believe that when you make a mistake, you must learn from it. And next time, do the right thing.
And the polls are reflecting this rise in Bloomberg support. According to the latest consult poll, Bernie Sanders remains in the lead with 29%. But Bloomberg closely trails Joe Biden by 1 point, 18 to 19%. Bloomberg's surge with African Americans seems to be coming from Joe Biden. Joe Biden is at 27% among African Americans, but Bloomberg is only 5% behind at 22. Sanders at 19 and Warren at a distant 8%. Former South Bend, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg is only at 4%, but the important number here is that Biden was once at 51%. And Bloomberg is getting key endorsements from African American community leaders. Congressional Black Caucus members Lucy McBath, Stacey Plaskett, and Greg Meeks have all thrown support behind Bloomberg.
I spent a lot of time speaking with black leaders and community members and listening to their stories. I heard their pain, their confusion, and their anger.
Houston Mayor Sylvester Turner has also endorsed Bloomberg. Turner said Bloomberg embraced diversity and increased New York City's quality of life while he was mayor. But none of Bloomberg's new African American backers brought up his controversial 2015 stop and frisk comments.
People say, oh my God, you are arresting kids for marijuana. They're all minorities. Yes, that's true. Why? Because we put all the cops in the minority neighborhoods. Yes, that's true. Why we do it? Because that's where all the crime is. And the way you get the guns out of the kids' hands is to throw them against the wall and frisk them.
So the question is, in light of these comments, will Bloomberg continue to rise or will his campaign end on Super Tuesday?